I'm going to make a short video carrying on from my last video where we looked at how we could make both the ground floor and first floor lighting points, which we're used to seeing with a two-gang switch and a two-way switch upstairs for the first floor light and just a switch that turns on the ground floor light. You know, we said when you come into the house, there'll be a switch by the door that turns on the ground floor light and one that turns on the upstairs or first floor light. So when you walk upstairs, you can turn it off. And we did this wiring diagram so we could have them all on the same fuse. If you haven't seen that previous video, this is gonna look alien to you at this stage. So I recommend you go back and watch the video that led into this one or the videos within this series. This series of videos has a booklet that's downloadable from the link in the description. And at the end of the last video, you see the drawings we've been using. At the end of the last video, I said you could change your two-gang switch with this method really easily, just adding one more cable in and wire an outside light, replacing your two-gang switch for a three-gang switch. So what I'm going to do now is just bolt this onto the side here. I'm just going to draw a little bit extra onto here. I'm not going to re-stick another piece of paper over here. I want to show you how we could just have those connections and actually go to another switch, which would be doing the outside light. I haven't got a lot of room, okay, so I'm going to have to make it in this area here, and it does build on the thinking we've just had. So let's extend this one through. So I'm just going to make the switch a little bit. It's actually physically the same size. We can see that, can't we? The two and three gang switches are physically the same size. I just added it in. So if we go, let's go common at the top and put these in. So bring a solid one down there, break that one there. Okay, so we've added another switch, another gang to that switch. So I want this one to be my outside light. So let's make our outside lighting point here. So I'm just gonna have three connections in our outside light. I'm going to have my line, which will be switching line, neutral, and CPC. So here we go. So I need to get a neutral to this light fitting. Well, we had a two connector block in there with our neutrals in, which we brought down from this light fitting here, a neutral, and we took the neutral along and fed it to our first floor lighting point. So there's already a neutral connection in there. So I'm going to use that. I might have to change it over to obviously a three connector. So I'm going to take my neutral. So this one here, which goes to my outside light, is going to be the neutral connection, and it's going to be blue. So I'll whip it out of the connector, bring it up, and I'm going to bring it into the center one there, and we'll call that one my neutral. So I've got a neutral up to there. CPC. I keep forgetting them in previous videos, as people keep pointing out to me. Let's bring our CPC across. I'm just going to bring it out the switch slightly just to make it easier. And the CPC will go up to my outside light. And again, as always, I'm going to strike that one in yellow just to make it look like a CPC. And then we're going to have a brown conductor, which will be our switching line. So it will go either L1 or L2. It doesn't matter which. So let's bring our brown conductor from here and we go up like so. That means we've got our twin and CPC or twin and earth cable bringing up our neutral, blue conductor, switching line, brown conductor, and our bare covered in green sleeving, CPC to our outside light. You might be thinking now, well, it won't work, Gaz. No, it won't work because I need a permanent line connection here in the common terminal. So in the back of here, the common needs to be connected to the permanent line. Now, is there a permanent line in here? Well, if you saw the previous video, you'll know there is, and we piggybacked off it to feed it into here. So we can come off again. We can come off with a single, so you end up cutting a bit of cable off, so you end up having a little bit of brown cable here, so in other words, oversleeve with brown, and you just swing it between your common, so you're linking the common across. I could come out of this one, wouldn't matter. Okay, I could come out of this one. So in other words, to bring my permanent line through. So let's bring that through. Shall I take it off that one? Yeah, so I'll swing it off here. Permanent line connection goes wiggling through the switch and connects onto there. So my permanent line comes up to my loop. It comes down on my three-core brown and makes this permanent line to there. So when I operate this switch, I change the position of this switch. So in other words, I operate the outside light. I can turn it on and off because I've got a switching line this side. I've picked the neutral up from when inside my switch from the connection and my CPC to make it safe. I've actually easily introduced with this method, where we brought the actual supply down to the switch off a three-plate method, Remember to check the previous video out for the learning. So we can have an outside light quite quickly wired from it. So imagine if you were doing a new build where you had just a two gang switch at that front door and they didn't want you to put an outside light in from the specification. If you use the method we've just expressed in the previous video, you can see how it could probably be quite an easy task for an electrician to come in afterwards, because at the switch itself you have got that neutral connection which you wouldn't have had in the previous videos in this series we looked at. And again, if you're thinking, Gaz, you've completely lost me now, we've got loads and loads of wiring and circuit diagrams for lighting circuits using the three plate, the two plate and the conduit looping method. And we are building and building and building on that knowledge. If you've jumped in at this stage, I may have lost you, and I apologize for that. But go back and look at some of the other videos and how we've built our way to here, in order that we're developing other techniques in order that we can wire our lighting circuits in different ways and make it easier for electricians. So in other words, running the same number of cables but having greater flexibility. And again, this now three gang switch, if I was to pull out the fuse here, it would turn off the ground floor light and the lighting circuit for the ground floor, because it would continue on and do other lights. It's not just doing one light. It would also turn off the one on the first floor or landing. Okay, it would turn that one off. And it would also turn off this new outside light that we've wired. And meaning that just by pulling one fuse or turning one breaker off in the consumer unit, you can actually replace this three gang switch now that's on the wall, say where you come into the front door. Wow, we keep going. There'll be more in this series. We will go on and look at using the two plate method in order to do similar scenario two gang switches as well. But we just keep pushing and pushing that learning on. If you've got any comments, leave them below. I'll always try and get back to as many of those comments as I can. However, if you do see someone in there struggling and you know the answer, I would appreciate you helping them out in the comments as well. And as always, I hope this video has been some help.